Have you ever used any Stable Diffusion model and your images comes out very desaturated and blurry? And you start to think if something's wrong with your PC or maybe you have messed up some settings? Well, no need to worry, because in this video I will explain you the exact cause and how to fix it. What you actually need is a VAE, which stands for Variational Autoencoder. It can be used with your favorite Stable Diffusion model and helps you fix all those issues related to desaturated and washed out images. But first, you need to know when and when not to use a VAE. There are tons of models where there is no need for a VAE, means it's actually baked inside the model itself, usually by the author. For example, here are different versions of the DreamShaper model. See the ones where it's written baked VAE? That means it's already baked inside the model itself, so you don't need to use it separately. But then there are many models which doesn't have that, especially a lot of anime and illustration style models. Here is an example of multiple VAEs in how they affect the colors and saturation of an image. So you guessed it right, there are multiple VAEs to choose from. But before you get confused, let me tell you that by the end of this video, we will narrow it down to just one or two of them, and that will be enough for 99% of your generations. Now, let's download a VAE and see how it can be used. Google SD VAE Original and click on this link. By the way, you can also find the link in the description below. It will take you to this page on Hugging Face. Go to Files and Versions and download this Safe Tensors file. Once it's downloaded, move the file to VAE folder inside Models. Now, launch Automatic 1111 Web UI. Before you start generating your images, we need to do a few settings. Go to Settings, User Interface and look for Quick Settings List. Here we need to enable SD VAE. Since I have already enabled it, so it's showing here. You can just type SD underscore VAE and select it from the list. Once done, hit Apply Settings and Reload UI. Now you can select all your VAEs directly from this drop-down at the top. Let's keep it to none and generate an image. We will be using the Cardos anime model for this demonstration. I'll be using this prompt here, which you can also find in the description below. Just copy and paste it in the box here and then press this blue arrow key. This will automatically load the prompt details to their desired sections. Now hit generate. As you can see, the generated image seems a bit washed out and desaturated. The color seems a bit off and dull. Now let's select one of the VAEs from the drop-down. I will select the MSE840K VAE that we downloaded from the Hugging Face website earlier. Now hit generate. As you can see, the image looks much better now and the saturation feels natural. Since this image was anime style, so let's try one of those anime style VAEs. I will go with the one called Anything 3.0. It's kind of the most popular anime VAE out there, which in fact is just a renamed version of the Novel AI VAE. I'll explain that in detail in a bit. Let's first generate our image. Boom! It got generated, and as you can see, it's a bit brighter than the MSE840K that we tried earlier. Although this can be subjective, so I will let you guys decide. Here is a side-by-side comparison of both. So tell me down in the comments below, which one do you guys prefer? Now, you must be thinking, I only showed you two VAEs, so what about the others? Well, I have downloaded 8 different VAEs, and after testing all of them, I found one major difference. Here is an XYZ plot of the 4 popular anime VAEs. Anything, Grapefruit, Orange Mix and Novel AI VAE, which also goes by the name Anime Final Full Pruned. All of them exactly looks the same. Even the file sizes are same. So let's verify if they are the same files by using a tool called FileBot. Let's drop all the files here and generate the checksum. Boom! As you can see, the SFV generated for all these files are exactly the same. So it's safe to say that we can just keep one and delete the rest. As you can see, more than half of the VAEs are actually just a renamed copy of the Novel AI VAE. For people who don't know what's Novel AI, it's a subscription-based cloud LLM which can be used for AI-assisted storytelling and image generation. In October 2022, a huge chunk of model weights and code got leaked in public. Later, this became a base for fine-tuning a lot of early anime models, which were released by the open-source community. So, popular anime models like Anything, Orange Mix, and Grapefruit released their fine-tuned versions of the Novel AI model with a renamed version of original Novel AI VAE. So that's why all these VAEs are just renamed duplicates. Since we have removed the duplicates, here is an XYZ plot with the remaining VAEs. Let's compare them one by one. This is the first one with no VAE. Then the Anything VAE, which is just a rename file from the Novel AI version. Anime Final, which is actually the original one from Novel AI. As you can see, there's literally no change compared to the previous one. This is KLF8, and I have noticed it works quite well with anime models. Bless 2, which I found out to be a custom version of Novel AI VAE. And then EMA 560K and MSE 840K. Both are default VAEs by Stability AI. Personally, I only use the MSE 840K. Later, I found out that both were actually fine-tuned from the KLF8 autoencoder. So, now we have come to the final question. Which one should you use? And the answer to that is... For all those realistic and semi-realistic models, go with the MSE 840K one by Stability AI. And for anime models, just go with the Novel AI one or the Anything one or whatever you wanna call it because it's all the same. But as a backup, you can also keep the KLF8 one because sometimes it works better with anime models. And that's it. Congratulations. You have solved the VAE problem. And none of your images will ever be desaturated or blurry. Subscribe if you found this helpful. Watch this video if you wanna know more about Stable Diffusion. And I will see you in the next one.